It is exactly 1 week since the army released Yusuf Kawoya, the man who was brutally arrested by armed security operatives and detained for several days at the Special Investigations Unit headquarters in Kereka, a city suburb. As a condition for his release, Kawoya was ordered to report back at SIU today, October 31st. Kawoya, who has been hospitalized since his release, has today reported back at SIU amidst difficult. At Kireka, the ambulance in which Kawoya traveled was not allowed in. Unfortunately, Kawoya could not walk by himself into the premises, and after several minutes, a few of his relatives were allowed to go to the offices without him. The relatives were later informed that the bond had been extended to the 13th of November
2018.
We thought that today maybe we are going to come here and be told that we are going to be taken to court and be charged. Of course, some of us don't know what the charges are.
It was further revealed that Kawoya had suffered severe injuries on some of his internal organs, including the brain, ribs, reproductive organs, among others. His family is yet to finalize plans of flying him out of the country for specialized treatment.
Of course, he has the issues to do with the lower abdomen, the ribs, and his private parts were tampered with. There's nothing that they have come out with that is sufficient, evident enough to convince Ugandans that he has a case.
Kawoya's family is also seeking the help of human rights lawyers to sue the government for the inhuman manner in which he was arrested, yet no formal charges have been preferred against him. The operatives who participated in the arrest will not be spared either.
Since he was tortured, nothing like any help is being extended. We believe that the only way now is going through court. We have already prepared court papers, and we are yet to find the High Court.
Footage of Kawoya's violent arrest by a group of gun-wielding men went viral on social media about 2 weeks ago, sparking off widespread condemnation. One of the men was seen hitting the helpless Kawoya with the butt of his gun during the chaotic episode before he was shoved into a commuter van and driven off to an unknown destination as people watched on. After the video had gone viral, security agencies denied involvement, which got people to believe that Kawoya had been kidnapped. However, a day later, security confirmed that Kawoya had indeed been arrested and was being held by security. Five military suspects were paraded before the UPDF Unit Disciplinary Court and pleaded guilty to unprofessional conduct. Rachel Nachuala for Urban TV.